shown a word on the left and a nod.
What we do here at the Sleep and Neuroimaging Lab at Berkeley is we try to understand the role of sleep in memory processing. This study is trying to understand why it is that sleep is worse in older people and whether or not memory problems are one of the consequences of that. What we found in this study was that sleep was an important contributor to memory decline in later life. So in other words, if you had bad sleep, your memory was a lot worse. What it highlights is that there's the potential that if we can improve sleep, we could actually improve memory. We had them study word pairs, specifically a word paired with a nonsense word. We wanted to have a memory test that really tapped a part of the brain called the hippocampus, a really hard memory test that would make it more challenging for older adults. They first see them and they study them, and then we test them on it after sleep to see how much of those memories they retained. We put electrodes on their head so that we can monitor their sleep using something called an EEG, electroencephalography, and we're monitoring their brain waves while they sleep. Their brainwave activity, whether their eyes are moving or not, whether or not their muscles are moving, and we can then use that to get a better idea of what kind of sleep stage they're in. Older people show flatter, smaller waves. They also show worse memory. And then these are in fact associated with each other. The smaller, the flatter the wave, the worse their memory is. Following sleep, we bring them to the MRI facility and scan them while they're performing, while they're trying to remember the words they studied the night before. We're interested in this frontal part of the brain here that I'm circling right now, but we're also interested in a place called the hippocampus, which is in the medial part of the temporal lobes down over here. And those parts of the brain are important for memory. And so we're interested to see how they're active while she's trying to remember the word pairs. Now that we know that sleep is an important factor for memory, we can then try to see if we can target it to enhance it, to improve memory in older people. It's a very important problem. It's starting to affect a larger and larger part of our population. And so being part of a research that's aimed at trying to improve cognition in older people is a very exciting process.